mathematicians, it's Justin again. So I played a bit more of my new game and I just realized that there's an inventory that stores all the things I've collected along the way. Check it out. I've got some energy boosters, a few items that increase my luck, and some treasure chests. I should really combine them to help free up some space though, so I can keep collecting. This treasure chest is 1/4 full, and this other one is 3/8 full. In our last lesson, we learned how to add and subtract fractions, but they all had the same denominators. These don't. In order to add more or take away some of the pieces, they need to be the same size. So, is there a way we could rewrite these fractions so they have the same denominator? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to find common denominators to add or subtract fractions with different denominators and record your answers in simplest form. Have your guide and notes ready, and let's combine some items. Since 1/4 and 3/8 have different denominators, an extra step is needed because we can only add or subtract pieces that are the same size. We can add 1/4 and 1/4 or 1/8 and 1/8, but not 1/4 and 1/8. Is there a way to represent 1/4 with a denominator of 8? Yes, since 8 is a multiple of 4, we can multiply to find an equivalent fraction. When finding equivalent fractions, we need to do the same thing to the numerator that we do to the denominator. 4 times 2 equals 8, and 1 times 2 equals 2, which means 1/4 is equivalent to 2/8. They represent the same value, but with different numbers. And now we have 2/8 plus 3/8, and we know how to do that. Pause here to solve in your guided notes. (2/8 plus 3/8 = 5/8). Nice work. And combining those treasure chests gave me enough space in my inventory to pick up this shield boost. Ooh, and it's 4/5 full. Perfect timing. I need 7/15 of it to restore my shield. Can we subtract 7/15 from 4/5 right away? Not yet. The denominators are different. We need to find a common denominator, so we're subtracting pieces that are the same size. Is there a way to represent 4/5 with a denominator of 15? Yeah, pause here to rewrite 4/5 and solve the subtraction problem in your guide to notes. 5 times 3 = 15, we can multiply the numerator by 3 so that the fractions are equivalent. 4 times 3 = 12, so 4/5 is equivalent to 12/15. And 12/15 - 7/15 = 5/15. In our last lesson, we practiced recording our answers in simplest form. It makes the fraction easier to understand. Can 5/15 be simplified? Yep, 5 and 15 are both divisible by 5. 5 divided by 5 = 1, and 15 divided by 5 = 3. So in simplest form, we have 1/3 of the shield boost left. Perfect. Let's keep combining items to make more room. Ooh, this luck potion is 1/4 full. And this one is 3/5 full. Is there a way to represent 1/4 with a denominator of 5? Nope. We'll have to figure out a way to rewrite both fractions before we can combine them. We need to find a common denominator, or a common multiple, that both denominators share. We can do this by listing multiples of each to find out which ones they have in common. Some multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 12, 16, and 20, and some multiples of 5 are 5, 10, 15, 20, and 25. What do they have in common? 20. That means we can rewrite each fraction with a common denominator of 20 and then add them together. 4 times 5 equals 20. To find an equivalent fraction, we also need to multiply the numerator by 5. So 1/4 is equal to 5/20. But that's only part of the problem. Pause here to rewrite 3/5 with a denominator of 20. Add the fractions together and simplify your answer if needed. 5 times 4 equals 20, and 3 times 4 equals 12, so 3/5 is equivalent to 12/20. Instead of just changing one fraction like our earlier examples, we needed to change both of them so they each have the same denominator. And now we can add 5/20 plus 12/20, which equals 17/20. Can that be simplified? Nope. 17 is prime and doesn't share any other factors with 20, so it's already in simplest form. All right, I've cleared up more room in my inventory, and I have nearly a full container of luck. Check it out. One energy source is 1/4 full, and the other is 2/4 full. Do we need to find common denominators to combine them? Nope, they're both already 4/4. 1/4 plus 2/4 equals 3/4. Done! Uh-oh, I don't have enough energy for this next challenge. I need 2/6 more. Well, we have 3/4 in our inventory, so how much will be left after using 2/6? We're gonna need to find common denominators to figure this one out. First, list some multiples of 4 and 6 to find one they have in common. Then convert both fractions to equivalent fractions with common denominators. Pause to try it on your own. We'll check it out together when you're done. Four and six both have 12 as a multiple, so we'll use that as our common denominator. Since 4 times 3 equals 12 and 3 times 3 equals 9, 3/4 is equivalent to 9/12. And 6 times 2 equals 12 and 2 times 2 equals 4, so 2/6 is equivalent to 4/12. Now we can subtract. 9/12 minus 4/12 equals 5/12. Is that in simplest form? Yes, 5 and 12 only have 1 as a common factor. Ooh, we've made it to another checkpoint. Remember, these restore a lot of health. And my health is very low, just 1/10. This checkpoint will give me 5/6 more. Sweet. We need to figure out how much health I'll have in total. Pause here to find common denominators, convert your fractions, solve, and record your answer in simplest form. You got this. Ten and six both have 30 as a common multiple. Since 10 times 3 equals 30, 1/10 is equivalent to 3/30. And 6 times 5 equals 30, so 5/6 is equivalent to 25/30. 3/30 plus 25/30 equals 28/30. Can we simplify that? Yes. 28 and 30 are both even and divisible by 2. 28 divided by 2 is 14, and 30 divided by 2 is 15. I now have 14/15 of my health bar restored. Nearly full health. Checkpoint complete. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that clearing up space can be helpful in more than just video games? Well, now you know that when adding or subtracting fractions, the denominators have to be the same so that you're working with pieces that are the same size. Sometimes, one fraction will already have a denominator you can use. Other times, you'll have to rewrite both fractions by listing multiples and finding a common denominator. You also know how to find equivalent fractions and how to simplify your final answer. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice adding and subtracting fractions with different denominators. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time. Hey.